My name is Fukutani. I'm from Tohoku University in Japan. The title of my talk is New Proposal for Tsunami Hazard Map Explicitly Indicating Uncertainty of Tsunami Hazard Assessment. In this presentation, I'd like to mainly focus on the uncertainty of tsunami hazard. First of all, what I'm showing here is a comparison between inundation area of the March 11 Tohoku tsunami and hazard maps which have been published before the earthquake. Red area shows inundation area of the March 11 Tohoku tsunami, and blue area shows tsunami hazard map. You can see a big difference between red area and blue area. What you know from the maps is that present tsunami hazard map in Japan is no more than deterministic map based on one earthquake scenario. We need tsunami hazard map, including information for uncertainty based on stochastic tsunami hazard assessment. And this is a research background and objective of this study. Since the tsunami hazard assessment includes large uncertainty, as you know, we cannot properly understand the uncertainty in case of using the only results of the deterministic hazard assessment. Based on the background, the object of this study is to clarify the uncertainty of tsunami hazard assessment, and we would like to visualize the evaluated uncertainty on the tsunami hazard map. By doing so, for example, local residents who utilize tsunami hazard map can properly understand the uncertainty of the tsunami hazard assessment, resulting that it might make a good impact on their decision making for disaster prevention. And this is a research flow of this study. First of all, we compute stochastic tsunami height in coastal region by using logic tree approach and quantify the uncertainty of tsunami wave height, and then conduct tsunami numerical simulation using assessment results of the uncertainty. And finally, we propose a tsunami hazard map explicitly indicating the uncertainty. And target region of this study is the Soma City, Fukushima Prefecture in Japan. And Soma City is located there. Firstly, I will explain details of computing stochastic tsunami height off the Soma port. And in order to evaluate tsunami height stochastically, we selected 11 earthquake zones, including the March 11 Tohoku earthquake type fault along the Japan trench, showing in this figure. We used earthquake zones, which are used in probabilistic seismic hazard map by HERP. HERP is headquarters for earthquake research promotion in Japan. We constructed logic trees corresponding to each earthquake zones, like this right figure. You can see many branches in the logic trees. Numbers of all branches in the logic trees are 1,800. Let's take a look at the detailed contents of one logic tree. This logic tree is for off Sanriku earthquake. Okay. In the logic tree, we constructed five kinds of uncertainties: moment magnitude, asperity position, earthquake return period, log normal standard deviation for tsunami wave height, and its truncated value. And for the moment magnitude, we consider deviation of 0.1 from moment magnitude determined by HERP. For the asperity position, in case that the fault length is more than 150 kilometers, we set three branches in the logic tree, northern part, center part, and southern part of the fault. In case of the Tohoku earthquake type fault, we set five branches in the logic trees, which shows this figure. We selected these slip distributions from many slip distribution patterns. These are generated by an engineering model. Today I will skip the technique of making the this strip slip distribution. And for the return period, we set three branches in the logic tree considering confidence interval. This return period of the earthquake is estimated by assuming the Poisson distribution. For the logarithm of standard deviation of maximum tsunami height and truncated value of the deviation, we adopted Annaka 2007's value. Based on the conditions of branches in the logic trees, we generated earthquake parameters, longitude, latitude, length, width, deep, lake, slip, depth, strike of the fault. By using these parameters, we can conduct tsunami numerical simulation. The calculation condition and the calculation domain is here. And I will describe how we obtain tsunami hazard curves, including the uncertainty of tsunami wave height. And after tsunami numerical simulation, we can obtain a waveform and maximum tsunami height value, H0, for each mesh point like this. If we use a log normal standard deviation as the aleatory uncertainty, we can draw probability density function of tsunami height. And this function indicates that tsunami heights vary around H0. And the slashed line area denotes exceedance probability of tsunami height H. And then plot the slashed line area with changing H. We can get exceedance probability curve of tsunami height. Finally, we can draw tsunami hazard curves by using the information for return period of target fault. Next, after statistical treatment of the 1,800 logic trees, we can obtain fractal hazard curves, 50%, 5%, 50%, and 95%. And simple average curves. Target point for these curves is the red point of the summer point in the figure. Let me move on to quantitative assessment for uncertainty of tsunami wave height. And we derive the fractal curves by using a statistical approach. We can evaluate the uncertainty of tsunami height from these curves. For example, a line of 845 return period is here, and therefore, average tsunami height with return period of about 845 years is 3.73 meter, 5% fractal, 1.21 meter, and 50% fractal wave is 2.69. As the figure indicated, tsunami height with even one return period basically have values in the wide range. Next, I will explain about conducting tsunami numerical simulation using assessment results of uncertainty and generating tsunami hazard map explicitly indicating uncertainty. And firstly, we specify the earthquake fault generating average tsunami height with return period of about 845 years as an example. And this table shows uncertainty assessment. And this table shows uncertainty assessment of tsunami height with return period of about 845 years. This average tsunami height is 3.73 meter. And the center figure shows a specified earthquake fault. And then we simulate tsunami inundation area using the fault parameters of specified earthquake. And in the inundation calculation, we use a nonlinear shallow water equation with nesting method. The most fine mesh size is 10 meters. the result of tsunami numerical simulation is here. The yellow line, yellow area is the inundation area due to offshore tsunami height. That averagely generates once every 845 years. Next, inundation areas due to change of fractile wave height are calculated by conducting tsunami numerical simulation using fault parameters of hypothetical earthquake, which slip amount is decreased or increased uniformly by multiplying scale factors according to change of fractile wave height. The scale factors are shown in the below table. We confirm that we can simulate these tsunami height at the point if we use the fault slip adjusted by these scale factors. And here is the result of the simulation. Blue area is inundation area due to 5% fractile wave. The yellow is for average wave. And red area is for 95 fractile wave. At least in theory, the return period of these inundation area is all about 845 years. As is evidence in the figure, there exists large uncertainty in the tsunami hazard assessment. In the stochastic tsunami hazard assessment, we tend to focus on inundation area for one return period. But it is very important to evaluate, quantify, and visualize their uncertainty like this figure. Let me conclude my presentation. We propose an example of new tsunami hazard map explicitly indicating uncertainty of tsunami wave height by using the analysis results of stochastic tsunami hazard assessment in the SOMA port. Since the tsunami hazard assessment basically includes large uncertainty, we should quantitatively evaluate the uncertainty, not only evaluating the uncertainty of tsunami hazard assessment, but also clearly indicating the uncertainty on the tsunami hazard map could help local residents who actually use the map understand the uncertainty of the assessment and make a good impact on their decision making for disaster prevention. Thank you for your kind attention.